When you work as a freelancer or as an interim, there is one skill you should have. Excel at interviews. Sure, you need to have the skills the company requires, but let's be honest, others out there have the same skill set or are even better. When you take that interview, you need to make sure the people you talk to want to hire you instead of the others. There are plenty of courses available where they teach you how to take job interviews. But these courses are aimed at people who are interviewing for a permanent position. And companies have different expectations for permanent staffing than they do for temporarily staffing. Thus, your strategies need to be different. For a permanent position, factors such as personality are more important than they are for a freelance job. Of course, you should fit in their culture, but they accept more mismatches if your skill set is right. After all, you will only be at that company for a relatively short amount of time. Most developers I know are pretty bad at this. They treat the intake as a job interview, and there are fundamental differences. I believe one of the core skills a freelance developer should have is that of being a salesperson. You are selling your skills to the company. I'm sorry to be the one bringing you the bad news. You are in sales. I know. Most people think sales is evil. We all picture that sleazy second-hand car salesman. Studies have shown that when they ask people to think about sales, over 80% have this image in mind, always an untrustworthy man and preferably one in a terrible suit. But the truth is, we all are in sales all of the time. Whenever we talk to our colleagues about a new way to solve an issue, we try to sell that idea. Whenever you speak to your spouse about that new piece of furniture you want, well, if you're a geek like me, talk about that awesome new toy you want, you are selling your idea. Studies suggest freelance developers who are betting at selling themselves and adopt a sales strategy in the intake interviews can get a higher hourly rate than others. And that alone should make it worth working on your sales skills. In the coming months, I will be working on a new set of videos with tips and guidance on becoming a better salesperson regarding selling yourself as an IT freelancer. But if you can't wait, I also give in-person courses to help you achieve that. In the meantime, try to see if you can find places where you are selling something, such as an idea, and see if you can determine what works and what does not work. Improve your skills and get hired for that freelance job you want, for that rate you deserve. It's not complicated. As with everything worthwhile in life, it just requires guidance and some practice. Now go and make that sale.